teamwork.
Yeah!
Great job!
Oh, that was more than teamwork. That was... luck!
Mooncake! Hi!
You really think he helped save the dish?
Of course! He's the luckiest good luck charm ever. Think this dish could be a roof for our new clubhouse?
I think we have our answer. Maggie, what else is on the big ideas board?
Let's see. We've got your map of the Crab Nebula, drawings of Jupiter's moons, a sketch of a highly advanced space station. Oh, a narwhal in space. Here we go. Your plans for a super fun and cozy clubhouse.
We still need 3 rocket cones, 2 astro poles, and a sofa.
A sofa might be tricky.
Just say the word and I'll drop everything.
No!
I'm okay on my own. I just need my moon scooter and a little luck.
I am unfamiliar with this luck you keep referring to. Is it some type of energy source?
Sort of. Hey, Slip! Can I borrow Lucky Lucky Mooncake?
I don't know.
Please? Please? I hereby solemnly swear to protect Mooncake.
That means a lot. I trust you.
With Mooncake on our side, this will be a breeze.
Breeze? That is an Earth-based atmospheric movement. Ella, we will never find a breeze in space.
It's just a saying.
Oh, a saying. Luck still does not compute. It was the stream of space junk that enabled us to collect the rocket cones, poles, sofa, and...
a black hole!
We did not collect a black hole.
No! Look! A real black hole!
Ooh, yes. It's quite the specimen.
Closer look!
Ella, stop!
Why?
Black holes pull in anything near them. Once something falls in, it disappears. Even light disappears in a black hole.
Interstellar! I guess that's why they call it a black hole.
But if you stay far enough behind this line, you are safe.
Mooncake! He's over the line! Slippy will be so upset! I have to get him! My space grappler turned into spaghetti.
Yes, spaghetti happened. That's what black holes do. They have really strong gravity. Gravity is like hands that reach out. And a black hole's pull is so strong, it can stretch things into spaghetti. Gravity! Spaghetti! Black hole!
You know I love your dancing, but
This is no time for dancing. You call it spaghetti, I call it bad luck. I need to get Mooncake back before he turns into space noodles.
Relax. He won't be turned into spaghetti. Yet. You've still got a little time before Mooncake gets close enough to be pulled in.
I won't let that happen. Oh, Mooncake. And after the promise I made to Slippy. Again? Maybe I can use the sofa to knock Mooncake back over the line.
Hi, Ella. How's it going?
Not good. I need help.
Huh? We're coming, Ella. Drop everything. Ella needs help.
Stay behind the line, please. Stay behind the line.
Wow! A black hole!
Huh?
Mooncake!
He toppled over the line. It's all my fault.
If he falls in that black hole, we'll be out of luck forever. Oh, Mooncake!
I'm so sorry, Slippy. You know what? We can still do this.
If you are thinking of staging another rescue attempt, I must warn you that your chances of success are 2%. Very unlucky indeed.
Listen, who was there when that pillar nearly fell on us?
Mooncake.
And?
Madhu.
And who was with you when you found that weird crystal?
Mooncake.
And?
You guys.
And who came straight away when I said I needed help?
We did.
And who was building a super cool and cozy clubhouse together?
All of us.
We have something better than luck. We have each other. Together we can save Mooncake. And we don't need luck for that. Because we're friends. Are you with me?
Yes! This view from our brand new clubhouse even better.
Well, I've recalculated Mooncake's luck, and he's lucky to have such great friends behind him.
Good one, Maggie! I better get going. It's almost dinner time. It's Saturday! That means it's spaghetti night!
Ella, where are we going so fast?
Dad said to rush home. Hold on!
Guess what Dad got us to give Mom for her birthday? Guess? Guess?
A telescope?
How did you know? It's a ring dust telescope for studying ring dust. the card. See?
Wait, you made the card and Dad got the gift? I want to get her something special too.
But the gift is from both of you.
I know, but can I give her my own gift this year?
I'm sure she'd love that. We'll wait for you so we can give our gifts at the same time.
But I want to give it to her now.
Give me 30 minutes. I'll be super fast. I promise.
What's everyone talking about?
What? Huh? Us? Hear that squeaky sound, Tilly? Sure you do. Let's go check it out.
Well, they're acting strange. You know, since it is a special day, it would be nice to spend some time together.
We will. Absolutely. But there's something important I have to do.
Important? Well, don't be too long. Wow, I sure can clear a room.
This gift-giving is quite lovely. Do you know what you want to get?
Something spectacular. Just like the gifts she gives me.
Like the socks with tiny asteroids? Or maybe a collision?
How do you give someone a collision?
No! Watch out! Collision ahead!
Whoa!
Whoa.
Went up and over and up and over.
I'm still going up and over.
Sorry, I was so busy thinking of a birthday gift for my mom, I wasn't watching where I was going.
In my family, we add to the family birthday song every year.
My uncle's birthday is next week.
It's your birthday, really nice. If you're hot, just eat some ice.
Thanks, Slippy. My family gives gifts, but your song just gave me a great idea for a gift.
Gonna travel through the galaxy, past Jupiter, Mars, and...
Guys, what rhymes with galaxy? Guys?
Is a great gift. So sprinkly.
No, I'm going to give her sparkly ice crystals to put on her desk.
How do I look?
Pretty, but melty. Aw, they'll just melt when I get them home.
Just checking to see if you're ready to hang out. We can watch Rabbit Robot run around. I'll make popcorn.
Yum. But I'm not ready yet. I'll be there as soon as I can.
All right. Miss you. Kisses.
You can still give her the telescope. It's even wrapped.
Or a birthday song.
Yeah, singing is great, Slippy. But I'm not giving up on the gift. There's so many amazing things in this galaxy.
Hey, I know where you can find amazing things. Follow me.
I'm not sure Space Junk says happy birthday, Mom.
You see junk. I see a sculpture.
Slippy, that's a great idea. I'll make her a sculpture.
Oh, so pretty. Hello, flower. Slippy, look what Ella made!
Watch out for my... sculpture.
Sorry. I'll fix it.
It's okay, Slippy. I like the sculpture, but I kind of wanted to give her something sparkly. And I'm running out of time!
There are many things that sparkle in the galaxy. Voyager probes, stars, ring dust, meteors.
Of course! Ring dust! That's what Mom's studying! It's perfect! Dust telescope. So, I'll get her jar full of ring dust. What could be better than that?
Nothing. Ring dust is fascinating. It's the rubble from asteroid collisions or even crumbs from blazing comets.
I'll grab it for you.
You'll have enough to fill lots of jars when I'm finished.
Thanks, Slippy. You're the best. My mom is going to love this. Bless you.
I'm so, so sorry. You look very sad.
It's okay, Madhu. It's not your fault. I'm just sad because I wanted to give my mom a gift from me. And I still have nothing.
Let's get some more ring dust.
Hi, Ella. I don't think I can make Tilly wait much longer.
Hurry, Ella!
Are you almost done?
Who are you talking to?
I need to find something that shows my mom how big my love for her is.
Ella, I know something bigger than big. In fact, it's gigantically gigantic. Ta-da! My favorite gas planet. Hello, Gassy. It's giant! When I feel wonky woozy, I come here. I really love the sparkle sprinkles. But I have something even better than all of this. Follow me.
Sparkle sprinkles? Wow. Are those diamonds?
These come from clouds and form in the deep atmosphere where carbon atoms are squeezed into diamonds.
Thank you, Madhu. This is even sparklier than ring dust. It's the perfect gift for Mom.
Yay! And I know something even
more.
I
can make her a bracelet or a keychain with these. Thanks, guys. Wait till my mom sees my gift.
So, how's it going? You think we can still hang out today?
Bye, Ella!
Bye, Ella!
I'm on my way, and I have a big surprise for you.
Ooh, I love surprises.
It's okay. We can get more. I'll just use my net.
Forget it. I'm out of time. I have to get back now. What is that?
That is a nebula, glowing clouds of gas and dust. This one is called the Pillars of Creation. It's where stars are born.
That's the other place I wanted to show you. When I'm feeling super wonky woozy, I like to hang out here. Hello, baby stars.
That's Interstellar Spectacular.
Too bad you can't just wrap that up and give it to your mom.
You'd need a lot of wrapping paper. It's 47 trillion kilometers. Besides, Ella has to go hang out with her mom now.
I know what to give my mom.
Wrapping paper?
Nope, a new birthday tradition. I'll be right back.
Now you've got me really curious. Can I take it off now?
Happy birthday!
The Pillars of Creation!
I wanted to give you something just as spectacular as you are. I know I can't give you this, but I thought that maybe this could be the new Ryder family tradition to come here every birthday.
That's so beautiful. It's just what I wanted, to spend time with you.
Don't forget my gift! It's a telescope!
To celebrate your birthday, I traveled all day long to find just the right words for this birthday song. The galaxy is full of joy and things that twinkle, but better than ring dust are sparkly sprinkles. That's my family's birthday song.
Aw, sweet.
To Jupiter.
Don't let the space monsters win!
We won't! Everyone is counting on us! Wait, what's that?
Space monster abort mission!
Whoa!
Whoa!
Oopsie, I guess I shook too much.
It's okay. Once it's back together, the spaceship Ella Slippy Madu will save the galaxy.
This time, I have a rocket ship flying song and everything.
Sure. Ella, do you have the rocket ship?
Maybe it zoomed away.
The rocket ship is made of a rubber-like substance called silicone. It cannot possibly fly on its own.
Glitch, did you see it when you were vacuuming? Huh?
Guys, look! Slime. Silicone. Silicon! Guys, do you know what this is?
Gross?
Proof that a space monster took our rocket ship. This space monster.
Slippy, space monsters don't exist.
But the silicone jellyfish does.
Wait, so you think the silicone jellyfish took our silicone toy? They're totally different things.
There has never been any real proof that the silicone jellyfish exists.
And I read this book, too. It says the jellyfish is only a rumor.
Rumor? Not looking good, Slippy.
Well, my Grandma Glappy says she's pretty sure she saw one when she was a little girl. And she never fibs.
Ooh, then the jellyfish must be real.
Those who claim to have seen it say the jellyfish uses its orange belly to blend in, so it is able to hide in the atmosphere of gas planets like Jupiter.
That's exactly what Grandma Glappy said. I'm going to find that silicone jellyfish and get our rocket ship back. Who's with me?
If you go to Jupiter, I would advise you to be careful around the Great Red Spot. Winds there can reach up to 432 kilometers per hour.
Wow, this is very windy. Okay, I'll come with you, Slippy. We can carefully check out the Great Red Spot while you try and find your silicone jellyfish.
Oh, we will find it. You'll see.
Yay! We're going to find a new friend! Ooh, I should practice my new friend wave. Hi, hi! Hi!
Keep your eyes wide open, Madu. We don't want to miss the silicone jellyfish.
They're wide open. And I see something.
Where? Where?
It's Ella. Hi, Ella. Hi.
I brought my mom's signal detector, Slippy, just like you asked.
Cool.
To
Jupiter.
Huh? Wait. I see something over there.
Ganymede, one of Jupiter's moons and the ninth largest object in the solar system. 40% of its surface is covered in craters.
Perfect for a silicone jellyfish who doesn't want to be found. Let's do this! Seeing a real-life silicone jellyfish is gonna be astronomical! Soon, you will believe!
Huh, I'm picking up some energy.
Is it the silicone jellyfish? We found it already? Wait till I tell Grandma Gloppy.
Madu, you're giving off some strong energy.
Sorry, I'm just so excited to meet the silicone jellyfish.
What's that? Quick, Glitch! I need my track analyzer.
If a silicone jellyfish was real, then based on the drawings, it would float. It could not make those tracks on the moon's surface.
My track analyzer has never been wrong, Maggie. Oh.
Maybe we need to look for something else? It says they communicate with pulses of light. Ooh, I like light.
I've got a ton of gear to put on a super light show and get that silicone jellyfish to come to us.
I guess we could set up the lights in Jupiter's atmosphere. Maggie said that's where they hide.
No, I said if they exist. It is possible that
to the Jupiter's atmosphere.
This place is interstellar! I've always wanted to see it up close!
Maybe this isn't the best place to do this! It's really windy!
It's just
Here we are, silicone jellyfish! Come to us! Come to us! We're friendly!
Whoa! You can fit a lot in Glitch.
If this doesn't attract the silicone jellyfish, I don't know what will!
Whoa!
Hello, friend! Can you see us? Hi! Hi, hi!
I see something orange!
It looks more red to me.
It's the great red spot of Jupiter!
I can't believe the storm winds make it all the way up here!
I'm gonna get a closer look.
No, Slippy. The winds are too powerful.
Slippy, stop! Maggie's right! This is so cool, but dangerous.
I really want to prove my Grandma Gloppy wasn't making it up.
I know, and I really want to see the red spot up close, but it's not worth it.
Whoa!
We need to move. Maybe we can search for the jellyfish somewhere else.
Maybe we should just forget.
I was also looking forward to meeting the silicone jellyfish. Just look at all those dangly tentacles.
If this jellyfish were to exist, and it does not, those tentacles would help them float.
Hey, maybe if a silicone jellyfish saw another one, it would come say hi, right?
Ready?
Ready!
And now to make sure the silicone jellyfish can't miss us.
Whoa. Interstellar!
Whoa, we should get them moving like a silicone jellyfish.
Let's bring it into the wind. Not back there. Over here. Come on. This is great. It's like we're a real silicone jellyfish.
Be careful. Jupiter's winds are...
Whoa! Whoa!
Seen anyone spin so much. Maybe the silicone jellyfish saw you.
Isn't that the silicone rocket ship?
I guess you were right, Ella. The jellyfish didn't take it after all.
That doesn't mean it isn't floating around out there somewhere.
So you believe me now?
You're my best friend, Slip. You never know. It would be cool if the jellyfish did exist.
And even if we didn't find it today, we could try again tomorrow. I can make other stuff we can use.
Ew.
I think I've also solved the slime mystery.
It was applesauce. That reminds me, I'm hungry. Snack time?
Good idea.
Split up and look separately. We don't have much time.
this place?
This hole is part of the Antoniadi crater. Technically a crater within a crater. The bottom is 9 kilometers below the moon's surface.
9 kilometers deep? It could be hiding down there. Let's go!
Ella, the museum is opening in 3 hours. We should be returning home.
Ella, I think I found it!
Wait, right there! I'm coming!
Exploration Museum. So happy you could join us for opening day. Ella, there you are. Did you manage to finish everything?
Sure did.
Anti-grav bubbles work? Popcorn is popped? Ticket scanning robots friendly enough?
Working, popped, and the friendliest. We even had time for a last minute search. Look what Slippy found.
The missing wheel. You kids, I can't believe it. Just in time for the opening. Incredible.
Yes, wheels are the best. I love wheels. So round, so spinny.
This isn't just any wheel, Madhu. This wheel belongs to the crowning glory of my museum, the first ever robotic moon rover, the Lunokhod 1. Kind of like Glitch's great-great-granddad.
Actually, this wheel is over 1,000 years old, so in human terms, it would be Glitch's great, 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 great grandfather.
Thank you, Maggie. Who would like to do the honors?
The search was your idea. You go.
Need a little help there?
Nope, all done. See?
Oh no! Mom needs me on Earth, but I still haven't finished programming all the info pods.
Don't worry, we can do that. Go help Mom.
You're a lifesaver. Thank you. I'll be back before the opening!
This is Japan's first lunar probe, Hiten. It crashed here in 1993.
I've done mine.
This feather was used to test Newton's 1687 law of gravity.
This one's done too.
Awesome. All that's left is the Lunokhod 1, and we're done. Oh no, that wheel isn't on right.
I can help.
The Lunokhod 1 was the first unmanned lunar rover. Built in 1970, it's an excellent early example of solar energy.
You're right, Glitch. That's the energy that powers you too.
Neat! Wait, if it's powered by sunlight, that means we can make the rover work again.
Maybe, but I don't know how the old tech would react.
Please! It would be the best opening day present ever for my dad! The coolest exhibit here would be even cooler!
Ooh, and a moving rover would make people so happy!
Okay, sure. We'll give it a try. Glitch, give me a hand with this. Great work, Glitch! One giant leap for robot kind. Yeah!
Dad's rover!
He says he can steer a little. Get it stopped!
It's up to us then.
Maybe we should call Bubble your dad?
Glitch is in trouble, and Dad's all the way on Earth. We can fix this.
Glitch, you're doing so great! Love
excited or scared?
Scared. Definitely scared.
He's not gonna make it!
I can't look!
I'm coming, Glitch!
What? Why'd they speed up?
Due to low gravity and lack of air on Earth's moon, there is a minimal friction to slow objects in motion. Newton's third law states that every action force has an equal and opposite reaction force.
What does that mean?
The rover is moving faster because you bumped it. It will not slow down without outside forces applied. Also, I am unsure if this is a good time to mention it, but the museum will open in less than an hour.
Maybe not the best time.
I thought it was helpful, Maggie.
Glitch! Aim for the gravelly bits!
But that'll damage the rover.
It'll also slow it down with friction. He says he's lost all control!
Oh no, I recognize this place.
That sounds bad. Is that bad?
Glitch is heading for the Antoniadi crater. It is 143,000 meters wide and 9 kilometers deep at its lowest point.
Toast if they go over!
Isn't there any way to cut power?
It's solar power! You can't cut power from the sun!
You know, I've changed my mind about wheels. The spinning can be a bit much sometimes.
Come on! Let's pull them away from the crater!
The wheels are working against us! What did we ever do to them?
But you were right! We're just not strong enough!
No, we can do it! Maggie, what else can we do?
Ella, I am not sure there is anything else you can do.
We need help, Ella. That's okay.
Never scare me like that again.
Almost destroying the Lunokhod. I know it's your favorite, and I'll understand if you never ever leave me in charge of anything ever again. I feel so bad for everything.
I'm not upset, Ella. I'm just glad you called me. It's okay to ask for help when you need it. You don't have to handle every problem on your own. I'm always here for you, okay?
Okay, Dad.
Now then, would you like to do the honors?
Of course! Should we turn the bubble on now?
Actually, no bubble for this one.
You got it to work right!
I was inspired by you and your friends. It was a great idea, and I think it adds a lot. Also,
the Lunokhod 1 was the first unmanned lunar rover. It arrived in 1970. But had its final adventure quite recently. It did indeed, Info Maggie. 1 minute to opening.
Are we ready?
Ready as we need to be. Wanna go open up the doors a minute early?
Do I?
What are you doing?
Leaving our mark on the moon. In 1,000 years, someone could put this in a museum.
Ooh.
Glitch, you too.
Now Slippy's taken the lead, but who will round Neptune's ice moon Proteus and make it back to cross the finish line first?
Bet you can't catch me!
Oh, yeah?
They're almost at Neptune, but can they find its moon Proteus? One of the darkest objects in our solar system.
It's not colorful like me.
Scan for Proteus.
Galatea, Larissa, Despina, Hippocamp, Proteus.
Bingo!
Whoa! prepared.
You're in the home stretch! As in, if you stretch like me, you'd be home already! Who's gonna win? I can't look! Wait, I can't not look!
You did it, Ella! Congratulations!
I almost had you.
Maybe next time.
And as the winner, I have a special prize for you.
The prize is a piece of paper?
Not just any piece of paper. It's a treasure map. A map Slippy's dad made for me when we were both your
age. My dad made this? Astronomical!
I never could find the treasure, but your dad told me it's something very special.
Ooh, special! That means it's special! And that means you guys are
treasure hunters!
Ooh. Scanning Treasure Hunter's treasure map.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to make your new bunk beds. Whoops!
Are you sure you don't need help, Dad?
Ella, trust me. You'll be sleeping in a brand new bunk bed tonight. Besides, you have treasure to hunt.
You heard my dad.
Time to hunt some treasure!
Yeah!
Behold, a map of the solar system. Each ring shows a different planet's orbit around the sun. And this is your treasure map.
It doesn't match up at all.
It's like a puzzle piece that doesn't fit the puzzle.
I love puzzles, but if it doesn't match up, how are we gonna find the treasure? Also, what is treasure?
Something that has lots of value.
Like a bag full of hugs?
Totally. Wait, Maggie, can you turn it upside down?
Wait, what if you flip it like a mirror?
It lines up! Great thinking, Slippy.
Now we are ready to treasure hunt. Spoiler alert, I do not pack lightly for adventures.
Spyglass, shovel, wood planks, windshield wiper, and a giant beach ball.
Where to first?
Somewhere near Saturn? Maybe it's rings? I know, not very specific, but number two is...
Ooh, I know that place. Wait, no I don't. It's nowhere.
Wait, number three looks familiar. Zoom in, Maggie. It's Proteus, the moon we raced to. Let's go!
Hold on. Proteus is step three. What about the first two steps?
We can skip those. The treasure's obviously at the end. Come on!
Skip steps? But if third is first now third? Is everything backwards?
Maybe Maggie's right. If my dad made this map like this, Ella?
Come on, guys. Treasure awaits.
Chest. I'll need a sub-zero melter, a cube...
I'm coming, treasure hugs!
Whoa! Madu! Your warm hug did the trick! Even though I did pack all the right tools for the job. Whatever, this is pretty great.
A cube? It's just a box.
Maybe the treasure is inside the box.
Nope. It's just a cube. This is so not treasure.
What if we...
Sorry, Slippy. This treasure hunt is not so treasury.
Propeller? That was quick. Everything okay? How'd the treasure hunt go?
It didn't.
Dad, did you invent a whole new way to sleep?
No, at least not on purpose. But that's what happens when you ruin the instructions.
It's not the first time you haven't followed instructions.
Ella, I love instructions. Okay, fine. Sometimes I don't follow every step, but why do all of the steps when the finished product is really the treasure at the end?
Guys, I just realized something.
You should have listened to Maggie and me and followed the steps. All of the steps?
Yeah.
See? I told you she'd figure it out.
What do you say? Treasure hunt back on?
Treasure hunt back on. I'll pack more gear.
Step one.
Is that it?
No, that is just a rock.
There!
Iceberg.
There!
Rock.
There!
Iceberg.
There!
Rock.
There!
Rock. Iceberg. Saturn's rings have 50,000 of them.
We'll have to search them all.
The ice and rocks are too hard to travel by space scooter.
That's why Ella's gonna search with the snowboard I packed.
Who's in the middle of nowhere? There's nothing there.
What was that glitch? Orbit? Is this the current solar system?
Perfectly accurate.
But the planets are constantly moving, all orbiting the sun.
There's nothing there now, but there was. What was it?
Mars! Oh, I love Mars! So red and sandy.
Woo-hoo!
And...
It's treasure time!
Hold on! Dust storm!
Please tell me you packed something for this.
You mean you want me to use one of my things?
Uh-huh!
Woohoo!
Slippy, hurry! Treasures.
Ooh, is that treasure?
What are we supposed to do with these?
I don't know. But I do know a super duper dad engineer who will.
Why don't you give it a whirl? This must be the race course Slippy's dad made for me as a reward for finding the treasure.
This is better than a bag of hugs.
Rematch?
Woo-hoo! Yay! Oh!